Hey, what's up guys? It's Austin here, or Luna. So I just want to apologize in advance for my voice in this video. I'm aware that I sound like a walking disease right now. I'm just a little bit sick, but I should be better within the next couple of days and not sounding like that. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this story time. Leave a like if you enjoy it, and let's start this. So this story time takes place when I was 17. I was hanging out at a friend's house for the night. His dad was apparently going out of town for the weekend, so he invited his girlfriend and then a bunch of his friends over. So there's probably like a total of 7 or 8 of us at his house. And he has a really nice place, okay? His house is kind of split into two. There was like the main house part, and that's where my friend's dad lived. And then there was like this cool little like guest house in the backyard. It was like a one bedroom, one bathroom, and a little kitchen type thing. And it was like this cool little guest house, and my friend would stay out there a majority of the time with his girlfriend, and his dad didn't care. Like, his dad pretty much let him do whatever he wanted, but I guess his dad didn't want him having over a lot of people at once. So him being out of town, that made my friend want to invite a lot more people over. So anyway, we're all hanging out in the main house. We're just listening to music, just having a good time. And my friend really wanted to play Xbox in the living room with everybody. So he asks me to go out to the guest house and grab his Xbox with all his stuff and bring it to the main house. And I was thinking in my head, like, I don't want to go out there and do that. But you know what? I'll be a good friend. Why not? So I walk outside. I walk by the pool over to where the guest house was. And to get in, it's like a big sliding glass door. And there was basically no lights on in the guest house. There was like one nightlight. But I saw like this figure move in the sliding glass door. And I was like, what the hell, like, it must have been the reflection or something, like, no one's in there. So then I get even closer, and I'm about to go up to the door to open it, and I see the shadow inside there move again. And in my head, I'm like, okay, somebody's definitely in there. Hell no. And I turn around, and I ran back inside the main house as fast as I could. And I run up to my friends, and I'm like, yo, guys, there's somebody in the guest house. And my one friend, the one who lives there, he's like, no, like, I mainly live in there. No one's in there. My dad's not here. Like, that's impossible. I'm like, dude, I'm telling you, I walked up to that door and I saw the shadow of a person walking around in there. And he laughs and he stands up. He's like, all right, dude, whatever. I'm going to go out there and get the Xbox because you're being a little pussy. I'm like, whatever. I'm going to go with you. He's like, okay. And because I said that, everybody was interested. They're like, what? There's someone in there? So literally everybody follows me and my friend outside. We walk by the pool. We walk up to the guest house. And my friend turns around and he looks at me and he smiles because he thought that I was crazy. And he opens up the sliding glass door to his little guest house. And we hear yelling inside. We hear someone go, hey, get out of here. And I realized it was his dad. I'm like, oh shit, his dad's in there. And my friend goes, dad, what are you doing home? And he flicks the light on. And we are all just greeted to a sight that nobody was expecting. My friend's dad was in bed under the covers with a teacher from our school. And right when we all realized what was going on, my friend immediately flicked the light back off and just slammed the door shut. And we all turned around and just speed walked back into the main house. And when we get inside, I look at my friend and I'm like, yo, I thought your dad was like leaving for the weekend or something. And my friend just goes, yeah, I did too, but I guess not. I'm like, what do you mean? Like, you just came home from school and you didn't check that house at all? Like, you just thought he wasn't here? And my friend's like, yeah, I would never even think to check the guest house. He's never in there unless he's cleaning. And like, I got home from school and there was money on the table for food and a note, so I assumed he just already left. I'm like, why would he be in the guest house though? Like, you're always in there playing Xbox or sleeping. He's like, I don't know, dude. I don't know. I'm like, well, did you know that he was dating that teacher from our school? And he's like, no, I didn't. Can you stop asking me a million questions, please? I'm like, yeah, man, my bad. And my one friend in the back just goes, wow, someone's pissed off that a teacher's getting fucked on his bed right now. And I just start dying laughing, and so does everybody else in the room. And I'm like, hey, man, he said what we're all thinking. And he's just like, fuck you guys. And after like a solid 2 minutes of laughing, my friend gets a text from his dad saying, hey, son, sorry I didn't leave yet. I actually moved it back a little bit. I'll be leaving later tonight. And I'm sorry you had to meet my girlfriend that way. And I just, like, couldn't help but feel bad for my friend. Because, like, such an awkward way to meet your parents' girlfriend or boyfriend or whoever. Like, you don't want to walk in on that. So anyway, after he sent that text, he sent another one saying, by the way, your friends are all cool to hang out here all weekend if they want to. And my friend was excited. He was actually happy everything went down the way it did. Because this meant that he could now have as many friends over as he wanted. And he was like, yo, honestly, I'm glad things went the way they did. Like, now I can have you guys come chill whenever, no matter how many people. And I was like, I mean, shit, yeah, that's one way of looking at the bright side. And he's like, yeah. And I guess in the end, it wasn't really the worst situation. It was kind of just a funny, awkward one. And she seemed like a nice lady. When I was a freshman, she was in my study hall once in a while, and she seemed cool. And her and my friend's dad were the same age, so, like, good for them for finding each other and dating, I guess. But for my friend, it was a little bit more awkward, I feel like, because he had a class with her, so he saw her in school. He also then saw her outside of school in his bed with his dad. So, just a little bit awkward. But anyway, I thought it was a really funny story time, and I thought you guys would enjoy it. Please leave a like on the video if you guys did enjoy it. Feel free to leave your story times in the comments down below, and subscribe if you're new. I'll see you guys all later. Peace. Yeah. Controversy, I should worry, but I don't. But I don't. That's not my girl, I'm not her man, that's just my joint. That's just my joint. I hope you keep it good, cause I've been running point. Running point. Very Adam Vinatieri, I don't punt. I don't punt. Gotta watch out, watch out, watch out when I stunt. When I stunt. On the contrary, I do what I want. What I want. Look out for the fam, especially my mom. Yeah. She could hardly recognize.